Okay, let's implement this. So I'm going to go back to our editor and scroll down to where we have our headings here. And I'm going to add a section around each one of these headings. I'll go ahead and do that and fast forward. Now that we have our sections, it's not going to change anything about our output. I'll jump to the browser here and go to our example and refresh. And we don't see any changes. That's because we're just adding these empty, unstyled containers around our headers. So now we want to style this middle one. Now the way we did that before was with a class. Let's do that again. Now, if you're a veteran of HTML and CSS and you're watching this for review, some of the things that we're going to be doing on our way to the ultimate solution are problematic in the long run. So if you see some things that raise red flags, just realize that we're going to come back around and look at what we're doing and talk about the long-term implications. But for now, for the rest of you, it's important to look at the simplest implementations because one, they can be useful, and two, you need to see these before you can understand what might be wrong with them as our template gets more complicated. So before, what we did was we added a class to our H2 tag. Let's do the same thing for this section. Now we're going to go through a couple of options here. First of all, what would we name this class? Right now, all that we know about it is that it's different. So let's use a class called different, and then we'll adjust our styles so that they apply either to this H2 tag or to this section. So I'm going to add class equals different. Now if we just left it like this, the same classes that applied to this H2 would be applied to this, which is that it would change the border bottom color, which isn't a big deal because this section doesn't have a border yet, but that could become problematic later. But what we want to do is be more specific with this selector so that it only applies to H2 tags that have the class different. And the way we can do that is by stringing two selectors together. So I'm going to click here and I'll type H2 and then we'll use dot different. And this is the way that we say apply these classes only to H2 tags that have the class different. And now we can create a new style for this section using the same format. So we'll use section.different and we'll create an opening and closing bracket and then we'll put our styles in here. Now the only thing we want to change right now is the background color. Let's go back to Photoshop and I'm going to use a color picker to find out what this gray color is. So the hexadecimal value is this. We'll copy this. I'll close this and jump back to the editor and I'll put the hexadecimal value in here. Now, we've seen the property that we want to assign this value to in one of the examples on W3 schools. It's the background color property. Now, there's more properties that we can apply to backgrounds, and we'll talk about those later. But for now, we'll stick to background color, and we'll assign it this gray value. I'll save this and jump back to the browser and refresh.